Okay. Hello, children. Hope you have completed the homeworks given. Okay, the numericals. Okay. Now, today's topic is a very important topic. We are going to see Gauss theorem or Gauss's theorem. That is, say I am comfortable with this Gauss theorem. I will pronounce like that. Okay. Gauss theorem. Or Gauss's law or Gauss law, okay? Gauss law for me in electrostatics. The pronunciation may differ. Okay, doesn't matter. So, what is this Gauss theorem? What is that? According to this theorem, very important. Okay, see the surface integral of the electric field. I'll write it. Okay, the surface integral. Oh, let me have some other color. The surface integral. The surface integral of electric field E. Produced by any source. Any source or sources, whatever is the case. Okay. Over any closed surface. Yes. Enclosing a volume V. V in vacuum. Okay, this is one. So, surface integral of electric field produced by any source over any closed surface, yes, enclosing a volume V in vacuum. Or, same. Or, the other words you can say. Okay. Total electric flux over a closed surface. Closed surface, yes, in vacuum. Yes. This or that. Either you can write, what is that? The surface integral of electric field E produced by any source over any closed surface, yes, enclosing a volume V in vacuum, or total electric flux over a closed surface in vacuum, S. Okay. 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge enclosed by the surface. What, therefore, this is Gauss theorem. See, the surface integral of the electric field. What is that? Electric field produced by any source. Therefore, surface integral of electric field means over a closed surface. Already we have seen E dot ds. It is a surface integral of electric field over a closed surface. In other words, it is what is called electric flux. That is why it is by C. Either you can write surface integral of this is given by. What is that? The whole this thing is given by here. Surface integral of electric field over a closed surface. Okay. Yes. Enclosing a volume V in vacuum. Or the other one, what is that? The total electric flux. The total electric flux. This one. The total electric flux over a closed surface is in vacuum up to this. Okay. That is given by this. What? Total electric flux. Okay. And that is equal to what? Is equal to. What is that? Is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge enclosed by the surface Q. If Q is the total charge enclosed by the surface, therefore 1 by epsilon naught times Q. That is nothing but Q by epsilon naught. Are you following? See, you can in see the surface integral of electric field E produced by any source over any closed surface S enclosing a volume V in vacuum. Okay, even you can write even R, I don't want. You can even that is equal to, that is the total electric flux, that is the total electric flux over a closed surface S, okay, in vacuum is this, okay, 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge enclosed by the surface, that is phi E, that is the electric flux, that is nothing but E dot ds, that is equal to Q by epsilon naught. Are you following? Is it clear? Okay, so this is Gauss theorem. Okay, therefore now what we have to do is see proof for Gauss theorem. Okay, for that, see, before that, see, the surface chosen, because what is the surface integral of the electric field produced by any source over any closed surface, and some closed surface is required in order to, if you want to apply Gauss theorem, some closed surface is required. Okay, therefore that surface, that closed surface, okay, therefore to calculate, what is that, we have to find out what the surface integral of an electric field, surface integral of a electric over a closed surface, therefore we want some closed surface to apply Gauss theorem, na? So that surface is what is called Gaussian surface, the surface which we need, okay, in order to apply closed surface, we need not to apply Gauss theorem, is what is called Gaussian surface. Gaussian surface. Okay, anyhow, now we will come to what is a proof here for that. See, this proof is this is, okay, this is not a final, this is Gaussian surface, right? Now see, for example, see this proof, this is the proof meant only for, okay, spherically symmetric, that also spherically symmetric surface only. What do you mean by spherically symmetric? I think I have say, for example, no, I'll before going to this proof, I'll tell you. See, there is a point charge here, okay, and if I have one point at a distance r, what is the electric field? You know what is the electric field? E there, E will be, that is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square, correct? This is the electric field due to a point charge, right? And what is the direction? Direction will be in this direction if charge is positive, okay? And at the same, see, I have at same distance R one more point. What is the electric field, the magnitude of electric field at this point, because the distance is R only? Okay, therefore it is also, what is it, 1 by 4 pi epsilon Q by R square magnitude. And what is the direction? Direction will be in this direction. Correct? And like that, if you take different points around this charge by keeping, what is that, from the charge, you had different points which are at the same distance, R. Okay, if you take everywhere, the magnitude of the electric field is the same, that is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R squared. But is it clear? Therefore, if you take locus of all these points, then it will be sphere, correct? It will be a sphere. So see, if you consider, see, around the charge, okay, if each and every point on the sphere, on each and every point on the sphere, the electric field will be, electric field, magnitude of the electric field will be the same. Magnitude of the electric field will be the same. But what about the direction? Direction will be radially, what is that, outward. this is the diagonal. Everywhere it is radially outward. If you take a point here, okay, if I want the electric field magnitude will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon q by r squared, but that it will be radially outward. So which means that this is what is called for what is a spherically symmetric. For a point charge, the electric field due to a point charge, magnitude of the electric field due to a point charge is spherically symmetric. Why? Each and every point on the sphere will have the same magnitude of electric field. That is why it is called spherically symmetric. Okay. Right. Now we are going for the proof here. Okay. For that, suppose I am taking suppose I have an isolated positive charge, okay, and it is situated at the center of a sphere, okay. I have an isolated positive charge which is situated at the center of the sphere. Okay, at the center of the sphere. Center is O, here a positive charge is kept. Okay, and the radius is R, radius of the sphere is R. Okay, therefore this is R. Okay, now let me have one point, what is that, P, on the surface of the sphere. Now I want to find out the electric field at that point. If therefore, what will be the electric field at that point? According to you have to use Coulomb's law, okay? Using Coulomb's law, okay, electric field intensity at P. Where is P? P is lying on the, what is that, sphere. Now I have considered a sphere of radius R. Okay, so at the center of which our positive charge is kept. Okay, therefore is given by at P on the sphere is given by what is E that is equal to vector Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R squared. Right. Now vector, now therefore I want what is the direction. So I have to, this will be the direction of E. Okay. And therefore this can be written as, what is that here? This is R. Let me have this vector. Because what is that portion? The distance between Q and P is given by a vector, that is R. Okay. Therefore, this is the direction, that is unit vector. Okay. Therefore, E is along R. Therefore, you can say it is R unit vector. Hope you are following. Okay. Therefore, this is, therefore, what is R? R is a unit vector. Okay. Directed from O to P. O to P. Okay. Right. Now what I want, now let me take a very small area element ds, okay, around this point. It will be, okay, therefore that this is ds, okay, around that point, because I am showing only portion of the it is sphere. On the sphere, the point is there. So you will be taking ds, means it is what is that, circular portion. Okay. Now I am able to show only part of it. Okay. Therefore, and here this ds. Okay. Therefore, what is the area vector? Area vector will be also, what is that? It is also perpendicular. It is also, what is that? I think it is unit vector here. This is a unit vector. Okay. Therefore, how do you represent area vector? Therefore, area vector, the surface ds vector is nothing but ds. Already we have seen. Okay. Now you tell me area vector. See, your E is radially outward. Okay. And area vector is also, what is that? Normal. Along the, actually it is outward normal. Now, therefore, that will also be in the same direction. That is, as your R, unit vector R. Are you following? Therefore, now you tell me. Okay. I hope you are following. N and R, unit vector R. Okay, and unit vector n are both are in the same direction. Why? Both are radially outward. Okay, right. Therefore, now this I know. Now, what I want is electric flux. Therefore, electric flux. Okay, over the area element ds is given by area element ds is nothing but you can say it is d phi e. Okay, because the element is very small and ds element, therefore electric flux is d phi e, that is equal to e dot ds. Hope you are following. Okay, therefore d phi e can be written as e. E is nothing but Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R square R dot. What is that? N ds, ds vector. N ds. Therefore, I can write this one as, okay, Q by 4 pi epsilon naught, okay, into ds by R squared. Okay, into unit vector r dot unit vector n e dot ds na. Okay, but what is unit vector r dot unit vector? I hope you are following, because it's a dot product. It is a dot product of dot product between electric what is that, electric field intensity and the area vector. So, what is r dot n? Both are in the same direction now. I think you have I dot I, that is equal to 1. J dot j is equal to 1. Here r and n are in the same direction. Therefore, angle is 0. Therefore, it has to be equal to 1 now. Are you following? Therefore, you will be getting d phi e as the 4. Okay. Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into ds by r squared. This is your, what is that, flux, electric flux over a small area element, that is ds. Are you following? But what I want is, okay, now, therefore, okay, electric flux over the closed surface area of the sphere, okay, yes, phi e, it is nothing but phi e, that is nothing but, okay, full surface. I have taken only what is electric flux through ds, but I want through the full surface, that is s. Okay, therefore full closed surface. Okay, therefore that is nothing but d phi e. Okay, and that is nothing but e dot ds na. E dot ds. Okay, this one, it is surface integral e dot ds. Are you following? Therefore, that is nothing but, what is e? It is 1 by you can say q by 4 pi epsilon naught, okay, into r squared, okay, into ds na, just now we have the ds, that integral. Okay, therefore e dot d phi e, already we have calculated what is e d phi e, what is d phi e. Okay, if you want d phi e, that is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught r square into ds. Okay, integral of d phi e means, what is that? Here you will be getting a full surface, the full closed a sphere, full sphere. Therefore q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, okay, r squared, okay, and over ds. Okay, therefore integral of ds, what is integral of ds? That is phi e, that is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught r squared. Therefore integral ds closed surface, that is nothing but, okay, total area of the spherical surface, correct? Total area of the spherical surface. Okay, therefore here I think, see, let me draw the once again. See, here is the this is O, and therefore here is your ds. Okay, therefore like that, integral of ds means you will be getting, what is that? Like that you are getting so many ds's here, ds, this sphere. Okay, therefore total, therefore integral ds will be, what is that? The area of the total spherical surface. Therefore what is the area of total area? That is nothing but, what is the 4 pi r square na, surface area. Are you following? Therefore what is that? 4 pi r squared, it will go. Therefore you will be getting q by epsilon naught. Therefore hence, what are you doing? Hence phi e, that is equal to integral of e dot ds. Okay, surface integral, e dot ds means over a closed surface, that is surface integral. Okay, that is nothing but q by epsilon naught. So this is your Gauss theorem. Okay, hence it is proved. Are you following? Right, now see special case. See, what is a special case? If there are here for only one charge, like that so many charges are there. Okay, if there are q1, q2, q3, q4, etc., qn charges are lying inside the surface. Here we have taken only one charge q, but there are so many charges are there, then what you have to apply? Superposition principle. Therefore total flux over the surface is nothing but, okay, therefore that is equal to, what is that? Flux by the first phi e1 plus phi e2 plus etc. phi en. Are you following? Each and every charge, okay, there are so many charges are there, therefore everything will contribute to flux. Okay, electric flux, that is nothing but, what is phi e1? Q1 by epsilon naught, flux due to the first charge. Okay, flux due to the second charge, q2 by epsilon naught plus etc. qn by epsilon. Okay, that is nothing but 1 by epsilon naught times q1 plus q2 plus etc. qn. Okay, therefore that can be written as 1 by epsilon naught sigma I, that is equal to 1 to n qi. Are you following? And sigma qi, if you take this sigma qi, hai na, the full sigma qi, if that is equal to q, total charge, therefore you can write here phi e can be written as q by epsilon. What is q? Q is the total charge enclosed by the surface. 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge enclosed by the surface na. Therefore that is, if the, we have done, see, we have proved only with a single charge q only, but now if there are so many charges, then what is that total charge? It's 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge enclosed by the surface. Is it clear? Right, one more thing is, if the charge, for example, it is a charge here, and the charge is kept, okay, in some medium. Some medium is there. It is not a vacuum, but it is some medium. Medium of dielectric constant K. Medium of dielectric constant K. In that case, if the charge is kept in a medium, okay, therefore what is that, instead of vacuum, now the medium is there, that's it, okay, of dielectric constant K, okay, therefore how do you write, what is phi e? Phi e, that is equal to Q by K times epsilon K times, that is nothing but K epsilon, kya hota hai isme? That is equal to epsilon na? Q by epsilon. If it is kept in some other medium, means then it is epsilon naught, means what is a permittivity, absolute permittivity of free space. Epsilon means absolute permittivity of a medium. That's all. Q by epsilon ho jayega. Epsilon naught, instead of epsilon naught, it will be Q by epsilon. So this is the Gauss theorem if the charge is kept in a medium. Are you following? Right. Therefore, let us see two problems then for closing. See, I have first problem is a surface element. Let me go for something. Let me see. The color, whether it will contrast. Oh God. See. A surface, a surface element ds that is equal to 5i given, okay, is placed in an electric field E that is equal to 4i plus 4j plus 4k. Okay, what is the flux? Flux emanating from the surface. That is flux linked with the surface. Okay. So you are given, now what are all the things given here? See, you are given ds and you are given electric field. Therefore, you are asked for phi. Therefore, very simple. What is phi? Phi that is equal to E dot ds. Okay, that is nothing but what is E? E here is 4i plus 4j plus 4k. Okay, everything you have studied in your 11th standard. Dot ds. What is ds? 5i. 5i. Okay, therefore you can say this 4 into 5. Therefore it is 20 i dot i. Okay, plus 20 j dot i plus 20 k dot i. Okay, therefore this will be 0, everything, this is 0, this is 0 because dot product both are 90 degree. Therefore you will be getting only here, what is that, these two will go, the I dot I means it is 1. Therefore phi that is equal to 20, it's been unit nahi diya hai, therefore you can say, because ds is not given, whether it's centimeter squared, meter squared, like the electric field also, what is a Newton per Coulomb or dyne per coulomb, nothing is given, no. So here you cannot write in 20 units. That is enough. 20 units. Is it clear? So this is the first problem with the selective flux. One more problem we will see after that. Okay. So second one. See, this is very often asked problem. This type is asked many times. Okay. S1 and S2. Are two hollow concentric spheres enclosing charges Q and 3Q respectively as shown. Okay, what is the ratio? What is the ratio of electric flux through S1 and S2? What would be electric flux through S1 if air is replaced by, actually it is air, it is not given, actually it is default, first it is kept in air, okay? If air is replaced, in air, wait, in air in, air inside S1 is replaced by a medium of dielectric constant, what would be the electric flux through S1? S1, it is S1, if air inside S1 is replaced by a medium of dielectric constant 3. Okay, very simple. What is the first? S1 and S2 are two concentric, hollow concentric spheres enclosing charge. Therefore, now you draw this. It is S1. This is S1. Okay, charge, what is the charge enclosed? Q. Next one. Let me have S2. Right. S2. This is S2. Okay. Right. Therefore, this is S2. Here, how many? It is enclosing. Three Q. Okay. So you are asked to find out. Okay, S1 and S2 are two hollow concentric spheres enclosing charges Q and 3Q respectively as shown. What is the ratio of electric flux through S1 and S2? Okay, therefore, electric flux. Okay, let me go for some new color because I'm bored with. I don't know whether it will give me a proper. What is that? Electric flux? No. Not a good. Contra is not there. I think this is the better one. See, what is that? Electric flux through S1. That is, let it be phi1. What is phi1? S1 is enclosing the charge, that is Q. Therefore, it is Q by using Gauss theorem. Epsilon naught. Let it be equation number 1. Then, electric flux through S2, that is phi2. That is nothing but how, see now, this is S2, correct? S2, this surface encloses how many charges? Q as well as 3Q. It is enclosing both the charges, na? Therefore, what is the total? Q plus 3Q by epsilon naught, that is equal to 4Q by epsilon naught. It is equation number 2. Therefore, what is your phi1? What is the first part? Phi1 by ratio between 2. That is nothing but 1 by 4. Are you following? This is 1 by 4. Right? Now, next part is, what is that? S1, actually the medium inside, it is replaced by medium, the air is replaced by a medium of dielectric constant 3. Therefore, K. That is nothing but relative permittivity and epsilon naught, that is equal to 3 is the dr, right? Therefore, now what is electric flux through S1? Let it be phi 1 dash, because okay, phi 1 dash, that is nothing but, yeah, now it is some medium is there, no, therefore q by epsilon. I told you, no, it is q by epsilon. That is nothing but q by epsilon naught epsilon r. Epsilon is equal to epsilon naught epsilon r. Okay, we have seen. And that is equal to, okay, q by, what is epsilon r here? 3. Therefore, it is 3 epsilon naught. Therefore, phi 1 dash, that is equal to q by 3 epsilon naught. Is it clear? Okay. Okay. That is it for today.